and may God bless this great Commonwealth. Thank you.
It's been just a month since we lost the Tone Bone as PM.
Don't trust the police, no justice, no peace.
And what exactly does an ex-PM do after losing the top job? Before enjoying a couple of tinnies and getting a much-deserved rest.
Aye, mate. What's the good word?
Then they do what they do best. Talk.
You're not saying anything, Tony.
Yep, Abbott has hit the jackpot, getting some sweet cash on the lucrative conservative speech circuit.
White people are pretty great. How good are white people?
God, I love being white. Rich white people are the best, aren't they?
Yes, last night, whilst on holiday in the UK, Abbott gave a keynote speech to British Conservatives at the Margaret Thatcher Centre for $500 a pop.
A politician who served as his country's Prime Minister until he was defeated, not at a general election, but in a vote by his own party.
Could have worked on the introduction.
Now, while Prime Minister, I was loath to give public advice to other countries whose situations are different.
Nailed it. That's a great policy, Tone.
But because people smuggling is a global problem, and because Australia is the only country that's successfully defeated it twice under Conservative governments, our experience should be studied. The imperative to love your neighbour as you love yourself is at the heart of every Western polity. But right now, this wholesome instinct is leading much of Europe into catastrophic error.
Well, if you're not following the Bible, then neither am I. I'm getting married to a man!
Essentially, his whole speech was about blowing smoke up his own ass, congratulating himself on policies that ultimately lost him the leadership. And he reportedly got paid $40,000 for it. That's a pretty damn good payday for what he'd been doing at home anyway. Abbott's post-prime ministerial activities follow in the footsteps of Howard, who in 2011 was demanding between $20,000 and $40,000 a speech, whilst Rudd moved into TED Talks and a job at Harvard. Gillard got involved in educating girls in developing countries. Maybe one day he'll do something else, but for the moment, Tony's just happy telling an audience how good he is.